In this video, we're going to talk about discussions in bCourses. So let's start by going over to our course navigation, and I'm going to select discussions. To start a new discussion, I'll simply go up to the top of the page here and I'll select add discussion. All right, so at the top, we can put in a title. And then we can put in a description. All right, and then let's talk about some of the main settings for your discussion. So you have some options around how anonymous you'd like to make the discussion, and those are sort of self-explanatory right here for these three options. By default, it's off. This one is important right here, disallow threaded replies. If you check this box, students will be able to reply to the main topic, but they won't be able to reply to each other. This next option right here, participants must respond to the topic before viewing other replies. Pretty self-explanatory. You can turn that on if you like. Big one down here, graded. If you select graded, what that does is that allows you to give students points towards their final grade for this discussion. So this discussion would show up in the grade book, and you could view these responses in the speed grader. I'm going to go ahead and just turn this off right now. And let's see, allow liking, self-explanatory. You can turn that on if you want students to be able to add a like to a post. Add to the student to do. This is sort of like for organizational purposes, if you want them to see this in their calendar. And then this last one, this is a group discussion that would require you to create groups for your class. And then when they have that discussion, it would only be within that group. So if you have 20 students in a class and you create four groups, there would be five students in each group, and they would only see the replies from the four other students that are in that same group, okay? I'll just uncheck that right now. So right here, you've got your available from and until time. This option to create a window where that you could say, well, it's gonna be available from January 20th to January 24th. And if it's in within that window, then students would see that assignment and then and be able to respond to it. And then after that, the discussion gets locked and they can no longer post to that topic. All right, so we're all set right here. I'm gonna go ahead and hit save and publish. All right, so here is the topic right here. And you know, here's where students can select it and start to reply here. I do wanna note right over here, you've got your options for this particular topic. So you've got your menu right here. And if it were a graded discussion, you'd be able to jump to the speed grader from right here. The thing that I really want to point out is this button right here, this unsubscribe, subscribe button. So since I created this topic, I'm automatically subscribed to it. And so depending on your notification settings, you might set it so that you get a notification every time somebody replies in that discussion. But let's say one of your teaching assistants creates the discussion. You would not automatically be subscribed to that discussion unless you responded to it. So you may want to pay attention to this kind of thing. If you see this box here that's not checked, this little flag that's not checked, you might want to turn that on if someone else has created the discussion. All right, so that's it with discussions. In the next video, we'll talk about creating new pages in bCourses.